welcome back to another episode of the Decades Challenge, and we are here today and we are watching Caroline as she is knitting some beautiful stuff as she has just entered her third trimester. So I have been watching a couple of people on YouTube that are doing the Decades Challenge, and I did get a few good tips from them, so I want to thank them in advance. Can't remember their names, but I will write them down for the next time and I will make sure to mention it. So as I said, each week I was going to give you a very cool, interesting fact that I did find out about the 1890s. And as you can tell, this is the second episode of the Decades Challenge this week, and that's because I'm actually having so much fun finding out all this information for you guys and actually enjoying playing with Charles and Caroline. I did a bit more research into the way things used to be back then as well, and because I was kind of basing it on the Ingalls family, I noticed that they always had a fishing spot that they went to. So I created, it's a fishing spot on their land, but it's technically not on their land because I have it all fenced off and boxed off. Didn't spend any money in whatsoever in creating it because I used debug items. So I did not cheat, because that's all I did. I just built a fishing spot and kind of like blocked it off from the place and everything, so it's perfect. I'm actually really, really happy with it. I'm going to show you guys it in a few seconds. So, did you know that in 1890, Wyoming and Idaho are admitted as the 43rd and the 44th states in July 1890? Now, because I'm Irish, I also wanted to find out what happened in Ireland that. So in June 1890, St. George's Market in Belfast is opened up to the public. There we go. There's your two little interesting facts about the 1890s. That's why I said. So I have her, of course, knitting, and as you've seen from our new little intro for the family, I did try to find as much vintage music as I could. I have him planting, because we had him going out gathering a lot of stuff. Lemon trees are so easy to kind of get, and you get a load of lemons off at once. So as you can tell, I have lemons all lined up, because that's because I want to have the outside barriers of their, you know, with trees everywhere, and I wanted him to work for this part of it. So that's why on our plants. Ooh. Oh my God, we've got stuff to harvest. Oh my God, that's awesome. I'm gonna wait until he finishes all his planting, because we have got a lot of planting to do, and then I'm gonna have him water everything once he's finished planting. Why did you stop? Why did he stop, guys? Oh no, he's finished. He's finished over here, but you are not finished with our lemon trees, so you need to start planting. Thank you very much. But no, we've got lots of plants coming up. We've got loads of stuff to plant as well. And we've got mushrooms to harvest, carrots to harvest, and strawberries to harvest. So I'm gonna get him to keep some carrots and some mushrooms, and then I'm gonna have him sell stuff like strawberries. He'll keep some strawberries for Caroline, but for now, and like in the long run, the plan I have for it is, you see this area here, guys, I'm actually going to kind of let him turn that into like a herb garden for her, but as a present. So we're working on it. Ooh, what's wrong with our girl? She's hungry. Okay. Well, girl, grab yourself some food. Oh no. Oh my God, we have food waste. Oh my God, I hate food waste. And you are going to eat that salad. So this is a little breakaway fishing spot. As you can tell, I've been surrounded by trees and like broken fences and stuff like that. And like they have this like kind of little walkway, which brings them in here to their own official kind of little stream, but the neighborhood can use it as well. Do you know, kind of way, like everybody can use it, because that part of it's not fenced off. But I have also made the house off the grid, so they have to come here to gather water and stuff. So like I'm very, very happy with that. Because their only way of keeping warm is they obviously have this fire here. That's their only way, and in bullies and stuff like that as well. What's Charles at? Planting. My man, and he's doing them. Oh God, I hate the way they moved them. I placed them outside the freaking fence. No, best go away. I know there's a mod I can download to stop calls and stuff like that, so I'm gonna have to do that now before the next stuff. So, but I'm very happy with the way the little fishing area turned out here, and we have still got our big massive garden here for all of this. This part is just blocked off. There's a fence there, but I covered it with stuff, like, so it wouldn't be noticeable. Okay, so Caroline, what are you in? You are in your final trimester, which is perfect because we will get to welcome some babies this season. Okay, so they only have 130 simoleons to their names. But back in those days, these teens, like, oh wow, human needs to go to the toilet and he's hungry as well. Okay, we'll just get you to stop that for a minute. So we're just gonna have him use this, wash his hands. And Caroline, you're going to have food out for him. So just give me a second. Right, what have we got? We've got a lot of stuff. We've got some strawberries, we've got some fish. Okay, it's 4 PM, which means it'd be like dinner time for them. We don't have any wholesome stuff here except for tomato soup. So you're gonna come and you're gonna grab yourself some soup. And Charles, you're gonna come and grab some as well, okay? With mushrooms and carrots and stuff. So we can pop some of these things in. Okay. And we've got like some fresh herbs as well for cooking and things like that. And these are the flowers that he's keeping. Okay. Well, like the way he says, like, any stones he finds that he'll sell them to his local cobbler or whatever, and we'll just earn our money that way. So there go, we're up to 215. Like, we're not spending an awful lot of money. Now, because I have it off the grid, we should not be getting like major bills. But we will still have to have some bills. Okay, so I'm gonna show you. Right. We are okay, because we've no power and we're storing any water that we use. So like this is fine. I put lot traits on it as well, so we're gonna have a quick look at that for you too. So I have like off the grid grit soil. Now I know I have on the ley line. I might actually just take that off for now. So I just wanted to have these two. And is there anything else that we can put there? Homie. Yeah, we'll put the homie skill on it because of the fact that the homie lot trait on it. Because of the fact that it has to be homie. And you'll see now the house on the outside, it still looks the same. Just I wanted to put wood, and I'm starting to think I should put that at the back door. But like any tweaks that needs to be done, I will actually do. Caroline is getting as much sleep as she can. And I'm just going to pop that soup back in, because the meals we have in there, we have to use them all up before we start cooking again. So that is one of the good things about this. I got Charles his own little chair, because I thought it was kind of strange that only Caroline had a chair. Alright, so we're going to have her finish off. She's knitting Charles a sweater. I wish I could have him read a newspaper. Or if I had a book for him, have him read a book. Dude, can you just change into your appropriate clothes? Because that's your outside stuff. Okay? There we go. Right, okay. No more fast forward. I'm sorry, guys. I don't need to fast forward. It's just like, oh, she's so uncomfortable. Okay. So, Charles, you are fine. Everything's right. So you're going to go out here. I'm going to pretend he's making her a crib. A wooden crib. Okay. And we can get one here. There's a wooden one. I'm hoping it actually downloaded for me. It was like a wooden kind of style crib. I'm going to type it in here, actually. Okay, so there's lots of cribs. I even have a default one. It's just pure wood. It's 110. That's not it. Oh, where's my crib gone? Alright, bassinet. Alright, I think I have it spelled right. But I do have a default bassinet. It took over the place of this. There it is. Right, I'm thinking this is more appropriate. The one I did get, it doesn't seem to be showing up. But this is the one. It's 100. This one here, it's 150. It's classed as the default crib now. So but I'm thinking it's perfect for this playthrough because it's wooden, and then you can just pretend like she made blankets and stuff like that out of her wedding stuff. Because back then they used to do stuff like that. They'd only wear their wedding dress once, or they'd keep it to pass it down to their daughters. She is like very sleepy, so we're just gonna have her go and sleep. Charles is out making the new crib. That's the way we're playing that. He's out making the crib because he knows that the baby's gonna come any day now. And Karen, of course, she's still doing everything she can, like to make sure that the house is cared for. Now, I know if you get to a certain knitting skill, you can knit. Ooh, we can knit a poof. I don't know if there was poofs back then, but we can do the knit. We can knit the poofs for when the kids are aging up, so they have somewhere to sit. So like, and like I said, we have the upstairs here as well, the loft up here. We have the loft up here, so when we have kids, and like, obviously she's gonna have to clean it and stuff because there's cobwebs everywhere, all that kind of stuff. I've thought of everything, and if we're going with the Ingalls kind of home, they just had like a big bed up here for the kids, and then there was like an area for them to study. There was like a kind of like a cup of press or like, you know, like a dresser for them as well in the room. Okay, I'll do more research. Okay, so he's done and he's gone in and he's popped it. Plop, there it is. Okay, there we go. And like the rose he gave her, I left on the dresser because I was like, we're not. Okay. He is sore. Okay. So oh, these don't work off the grid. Oh my god, we're gonna have to get off the grid stuff. Okay, I completely forgot about that part of it. But since like the whole updates and stuff, like they have an off the grid section, so we can get rid of that, and we can get rid of this sink. We can, oh, we have a crappy toilet we can get. Okay, we get the crappy toilet. Okay, and it's a wooden bath, and then does this work off the grid? Okay, there you go, they work off the grid. Okay, grand. I'm gonna put the money back down to, is it 200 or something now? I'm going to put it down to 200, only because I don't know how much we had, so I'll put it back down to 200, okay? And there we go, we've got stuff that's going to work off the grid now, so he can go to the toilet. Alright, he can get himself a quick bath, and he can wash his hands, okay? Actually, he won't have to wash his hands if he's just let him go do all that stuff, and then when he's done, like, he can do all of the stuff like getting the water because we are off the grid. Thank god the fridge works off the grid. And like, we have a way of keeping all the food kind of fresh because you know, water and stuff. Oh god, I'm a disaster. I'm learning as I go along, but I'm having a blast at this. So what else can we do? Alright, we've done the garden pot. Like, I want to do another garden pot because I want to have a tree out the front here for her. And he's going to plant like tulips and stuff for her at the front. This is really, really messing up my head right now. Okay, how do we do with all the lemons? Did we plant all of the lemons? We didn't. Did we plant most of them? Okay, so we've still got lots of stuff for him to plant. Ooh, do we have stuff to evolve? Ooh, we have stuff to harvest. That's mad. What is this? A coconut tree. I don't remember getting a coconut. Pomegranate. Okay, let's plant that. Are you in season? You are in season. Okay, that's a bit weird. Okay, let's just get him to plant everything. Make sure he plants everything now. Because she like a present to her. Oh, he banged himself with a hammer. Giving like a present to her after she gives birth to his son or his daughter is he's gonna, well, I have a gift for you, and then he's just gonna give her these plant pots, and then he's gonna give her three of the flowers. So he's gonna give her a rose, a bluebell, and a chrysanthemum for her to plant. Like, we have loads of snapdragons, so I'm not going to get him to do any more snapdragons unless we plant them here, but we'll see. And he's going to give them to her. She's going to plant them in the oaks in the front of the house. And then and that's, if he has a son, he'll probably go big and do a big kind of plot here for her and make her a wooden bench for outside and stuff like that. Because back then they worked with their hands all day long, especially if they had their own farms. So that was something. And she's chatting with him. Oh my god, what a baby. She doesn't look overly big, so I think it's going to be just one baby, and I think it's going to be a girl. So, change. Outfit. Can we just put you in your nice pose? Her outfit just looks too cute for her to just be all stuck in the cardigan. Okay, my dear. Alright, you're going to go back home. Inside, and you're going to start prepping for the baby. So, like, you're going to need another book. I know it's 60 simoleons, guys, but we're doing it. Okay? Because she's thinking about, like, putting a rug here in front of the crib. She wants to knit onesies and stuff. So, I know you can do that when you get to a certain level. I just don't know when. And, like, it's not like you can pop to a clothes shop back in 1890. And if you could, you had to have a lot of money to back yourself up. So that's why Charles works as a manual labourer at the weekend to get the extra income in, but he still has his farm and everything to maintain the rest of the time. He is very buzzed, very tired. Wow, like, it's very lean. Talk to a plant. Right, well, Charles, you're going to go ahead into bed, and then Carol, you are going to follow. It's interesting though, if they had timepieces to keep an eye on time, or if it was like something like that sundial thing. That's very strange. I just really want to. Okay, so what does she have here on the counter? What is that? Looks like asparagus. And that looks like bread. I don't remember this stuff out. Oh my god, it's a disaster. So I'm trying to figure out how they would have a family portrait done. Would they have to go somewhere and have someone take a picture of them? And if that's the case, do I have to wait until their kids are old enough to take a family portrait? I don't know. I'll have to figure it out, guys. Like an old fashioned camera. Oh yeah. That would be something. Alright, she finished her project. Awesome. Did I get her to do the same colour again? I think I did. Okay, so pop that there into the crib. Girl, you need a toilet. Okay, we'll use this toilet. Okay, you go use the toilet, and then we're just gonna have to get some leftovers and then go back to sleep. Actually, it's very early, so Charles, you should be up. So Charles, you go grab yourself some food, okay? You have to get back to work. That's the life of a farmer. So he has to go, and then he has to maintain all of these. And then we have to have him go out, and he has to go and sell all his crops. He has to go sell everything. Is this one? Okay, dude, let's go. Oh, Karen's going to labor, guys. Karen's going to labor. Okay. Alright, Charles, you need to go and do some work. Go work. That's what they used to do. They used to do the whole. This is where she'd need a friend to come home. Because she has no friends. Girl, you're gonna have to come and have baby. You're about to get so much tired, so much more tired. Okay, who is excited for our first baby in the Decades Challenge? So we're going to look up baby names for the 1890s. Okay. All right, we have a John, Mary, William, Anna, James, Margaret. Okay, but if I was going to go for the English children, I might actually look up the names of the English family children. And we might use some of their names. Okay, so we have Mary, Laura, Carrie, Friedrich, Grace, Pearl. Okay, so what did we have? Oh my god, we had a boy. Oh my god, we had a boy. Okay. I'm thinking, because it's a tradition still to this day, this is going to be Charles Junior. So CJ. Oh, good heck. Okay. Let's go with Laura. Any of you watch it? Okay, so Laura Elizabeth. Okay. So Laura Elizabeth Sullivan. Can I put in the H? Alright, well, we'll do Laura Beth. We'll do Laura Beth. Okay. Yay! We had twins! Where's the other crib? Oh, it's up over here. Okay, let's go and move the crib down. Okay, so I'm gonna have to wait until she pops the baby back. So we have a boy and a girl. We've got twins. So we have Charles Jr. and we have Laura Beth. Oh my god. So that's because it had on the ley line, isn't it? It's because it had on the ley line. Okay, so you're gonna. Alright. No. We've got babies that need to be fed. We can only breastfeed. There we go. I'm gonna say like a doctor came home. Like a doctor did a home this app. Oh wow, okay. And when you're done with that girl, you're gonna have to open up and just go and have sleep. He is very, very happy, I think. New baby, love Lauren. You are fine, dude, because of the fact that you just do the work in. Good, you keep doing the work in, and then you come in and meet your children. So she is straight away in there doing some jobs and stuff. Okay. So you look after the baby first, and then you get to get some sleep, girl. Okay. Change nappies. Right, girl. Alright, okay, I'm just gonna have, like, Laura's gone. Okay. You need to sleep. Okay. Pop this back in the fridge. And Charles, you are out making sure that we have plenty of garden and stuff, and make it some money as well. He's not liking planting all these lemons. But hey, we get to have some. Alright, ooh, he's level 5 gardening all. Yeah, okay. So we have to spend $1,000 on kids' stuff, and she just, they both need that aspiration, but we can't do that right now. We're gonna have to make enough money to be able to do that. So, both babies are sleeping. Charles is out doing the gardening. So she's gonna have to get up now when she's had a little bit more rest, and she's gonna have to, because they've had baby, we're going to make it mandatory. Alright, is it mandatory? meant to be off the grid, or can we just like have a certain amount of power as long as we have money to pay bills? Or I'm gonna take it off the grid because she's meant to be able to cook and stuff. I'm just gonna take that off then. Just for the fact that she's meant to be able to. So what she's gonna do is she's gonna do up a big ham dinner. Hopefully we have enough for it. A big ham dinner. Because obviously they've had their baby. So we've got Charles Jr., who is the eldest. So he's our heir. He's gonna carry on the family name. So I'm just gonna switch the cribs around so I know who's who. So I can see who's who. I do have this mod where I could get birth certificates. Alright, I'm hoping we have enough. Okay, oh, they're free. Okay. So doctor came, and what he did, that's not available yet. And he did up the birth certificates for the children. Okay. I think they would actually have them. Oh, we can name it. Awesome. Okay, that must be a mod I have. So we've got Charles. Junior. Perfect. And then we've got Laura Beth. Charles is the crybaby. Okay. So she's going to cook a ham dinner. Now we've already paid for it, so we can cook it. Where are you putting that girl? Where are you putting it? Okay, can you just go change Charles Jr.'s nappy before he has a heart attack? Okay, there we go. When she comes back out, she can resume this. Alright, she's level 2 parenting already. How are you doing? Okay. Oh my god, my aesthetic is gone everywhere. Oh my god. Oh, it's freaking me out. Okay, so that's a lemon tree. Green bean. Okay, so I have a lot of meat to do. I'm just getting him to finish off working because we need him to weed. We need him to spray our books. And sell strawberries and stuff like that. It's already doing half the day, like, and he still hasn't met his children. How's my girl doing? Awesome. She's baking a nice big ham dinner for him. I just want to come over here, just want to warm himself up. And can we knit onesies yet? No. I think the higher we get in skill, the better. Stuff that she's in her inventory. Okay, I don't know where that jumped. Did she go to Charles already? Okay, Charles wanted to go. Going good, 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 good. I'm just gonna have her. And she's made a nice roast dinner. We'll pop that in the fridge. Oh my god, I got that money. Oh my god, look at the money. We can actually spend $1,000 on kid stuff. Very soon. Okay, he's spraying. Awesome, okay. Right, Caroline. I'm going to take out the ham dinner. I'm going to have him come and meet his children. So he's going to cuddle. He has to have a good relationship, I think, more with Charles. But if I'm going down the House on the Prairie route, he had a very close relationship with Laura. So, do I already have him cuddling? You do. We'll just like have him cuddle and meet his children. And talk to his children. Then he's going to come, he's going to give Caroline a kiss because she did a fantastic job and she's actually even some does she know? Okay, Charles wants to give you a kiss, my dear. She got for it now. She didn't wish. Okay, so we're gonna have her pull out the dinner. Where's our lovely ham dinner she's after making? And then she's gonna call it to the grand meal. Okay, go call to the meal. And then I'm gonna let you then go and have a nap while he is. So the thing about all of this is, like, any time they have to do the, you know, the schnoo-schnoo, it has to be to try for a baby. Because, they had lots of kids back then, so it was like there was no birth control or anything like that. I'm going to be honest, I'm not looking forward to that aspect of this. But, you know, they had, like, 4 children. English family did. They would have had 5, only their son passed. But I'm not going to make them do it because she's just giving birth. I'm going to let her have a break, okay? If we do the schnoo-schnoo, I'm not going to do, like, we can't do a pregnancy test around to find out, so we'd have to wait. It's like a 3-day wait. So, I don't like that. But, like, that's, like, technically 9 months. It'd be like a celebratory one, except, but like they're like, oh, it's fine, you've just given birth, it's not, nothing's gonna happen, it's perfectly okay. Yeah. You two are meant to go up and do schnoo-schnoos. He's good for Joseph's guy, he's gonna get some questions. So you have to go and Challenge with our beautiful twins, Charles Jr. and of course Laura Beth. But guys, I'm going to end the episode here. I hope you've enjoyed it, and if you're new to the channel, I want to welcome you to the Pear Bear Squad, and I shall see you guys in another episode. Bye.